Welcome to Wrocław, Poland. This is one of the most breathtaking cities here in Poland. One city that I super suggest you to visit. And one city where I lived for almost 1 year and a half. I can be pretty specific regarding the time that I spent here because it is exactly how much it lasted my longest relationship, but that's probably a story for another video. This mess is the fault of an Italian author, Federico Moccia, who advertised that if you love somebody, you should lock your love on some bridges all over the world. The city is full of islands and rivers, and therefore there are lots of bridges. Probably the city with most bridges in Poland. Which makes it perfect for a romantic relationship, or if you simply want to have a relaxing walk between all this beauty of churches and cathedrals. By the way, I do not normally dress up like that for the videos. I just came here for a party and I'm left without clothes and I wanted to shoot a vlog. You can actually go up there on the tower and admire the city from an incredible point of view. But if you don't want to pay the ticket to go up, the details of this church are still incredible. I think that the tower might be closed because of COVID, but there is no explanation written. Okay, they are restoring it, so let's move on. Let's leave this beautiful part of the city and let's go find some dwarves. I am inside the Hala Targowa. There is a Hala Targowa in almost every city in Poland. It's the place where you can find good and cheap food at a reasonable price. Anyway, the topic of this video has nothing to do with markets, flowers, and food. The topic of today's video is about why in Wrocław, Poland, there are so many dwarves, and why Wrocław is the most anti-communist city in Poland, and why the two things are connected. This mess started in the 80s when here in Wrocław was born a Polish anti-communist underground movement called the Orange Alternative. By the way, this is the beautiful town hall. It's a museum inside. There is a nice restaurant. You can access it from the side and you will go in the underground. The goal of this movement was to offer the people a different way of opposition against the authoritarian communist regime. These guys, they realized that the only way to fight the authorities was to do a peaceful protest using ridiculous elements. Soon everything became so absurd and nonsensical. Not only they started dressing up in orange, not only they started covering the communist slogans with funny sentences and dwarf images, but they also started dressing up like dwarves. Soon the situation started to look so incredibly dumb. Imagine that the year where I was born, in the 88, it culminated with a protest in June, just 5 months after I was born, where they did arrest 77 Santa Claus, all the people dressed up in orange, and I do not know how many dwarves. Anyway, even if there was sadness for living under the pressure of a huge communist regime, this movement, the Orange Alternative, they were able to create something funny. For example, if the police was questioning you, they would make you questions like, why did you participate to an illegal dwarf meeting? And they would simply laugh at them and say, dwarves? What? Nowadays, this city is so relaxing and beautiful and there are dwarves everywhere. The first 5 statues, they were placed on the streets in 2005 and they were designed by a graduate of the Academy of Art here in Wrocław, Tomasz Maciek. And then, since then, there were placed over 300 dwarfs all over the city. Practically, if you walk all over Wrocław, 300 of them are hidden somewhere, therefore watch your feet. Today's dwarfs are not only there to remember you about the past, but also to show you which business is just in front of that little statue, or to remember you the history of the place. Like the top of this church where they were throwing down witches. The Orange Alternative was a great way to do protests that hopefully it will be replicated nowadays. Nothing harmful, just a funny and peaceful way to protest about something that you feel you have the right to have. And then in the year 89, when the Berlin Wall was destroyed and Solidarność was born, finally Poland was free of this regime. If you enjoyed this video, please smash that subscribe button, hit that like button, share it with your friends, and thank you so much for watching. Keep reading and believing in dreams. Ciao!